안녕하세요.
Greetings, I'm Dr. Park Jung-chul, and I'm going to talk about what kind of treatment plan you need for implant placement. Immediate implant placement. It has a huge advantage in that it reduces treatment time, but there's a significant burden in surgery and delayed placement. Healing is sufficiently done, but the treatment period becomes elongated. You need to decide when you're going to place the implant after extraction, and this is a very important decision. In order to help you make a correct decision, I have prepared this lecture. Together, let's think about when you're going to place the implant and the strategy. First, the contents. I'm going to talk about two things. First, when you're going to place the implant after extraction, the placement period. Second is, in order to determine the period, the extraction socket shape is very important, and the classification depending on the resorption level of the socket and the treatment strategy will be discussed. First, let's look at when you're going to place the implant after extraction. In the early days, after extraction, people thought 8 to 12 month healing period was necessary to place the implant. After that, first, bone must be filled in the socket to gain a good initial stability when you place the implant. Second, the two-stage surgery was basic protocol in those days, so sufficient healing of the gingiva was necessary for primary closure after surgery. However, we don't wait this long unconditionally. At times, we do immediate implantation, and at times, we give the patient sufficient healing period and place the implant. Let's look at the standard for when you place the implant and the reasons for that. As the extraction socket heals, what kind of changes are there? After extraction, the changes in extraction socket, there can be two perspectives. First, the internal change of extraction socket where the roots were located, how much bone fill is done. Second is the external changes of the extraction socket.
Compared with the width of the socket after extraction, how much has the width of the extraction socket decreased?
After extraction, how much bone fill has been achieved? Let's look at the internal changes first. In a sound extraction socket, in 4 months, bone fill is made. If you look at this literature, one of the main reasons for extraction is because of perio disease. In that case, more so than the sound extraction socket, the bone fill occurs 2 times slowly. The diseased socket heals much slower than the healthy socket.
In summary, if you wait for natural healing in a diseased socket, you may have to wait very long.
Second, the external changes of the socket. 50 years ago, Carson announced a literature that the extraction socket resorbs significantly after extraction. If you look at the recent literature, after extraction, socket changes occur very severely. Let's look at Scrub's literature, which is quoted very frequently. In this literature, vertical resorption after extraction within a year, 1.2 millimeter resorption occurs, and horizontally after 3 months, a 30% resorption occurs. And after 1 year, 50% of horizontal resorption occurs. Conclusion. So vertical bone resorption is comparatively less to horizontal bone resorption. So half the bone width is resorbed. Alveolar bone loss after extraction leads to unfavorable position of the implant, and aesthetically as well as the biodynamically, the prosthesis is positioned unfavorably. Due to these reasons, if you just wait after extraction is done, then the treatment period will become elongated and alveolar bone can be very severely resorbed. In order to solve these issues, immediate implantation was proposed. In 1991, Basile suggested pilot procedure for immediate implant placement after extraction. And 2 years later, Basile also talked about the pros of immediate implantation. More so than thought, there were good results. Implant placement after extraction. A lot of research has been done on the period. In 1993, Wilson first categorized the period immediate, recent, delayed, and mature. But there was no explanation about the period. And in 1999, Mayfield, for the first time, talked about the period, and classification started since immediate, delayed, which is 6 to 10 weeks later, and late placement, 6 months later. This classification was announced. Immediate implant placement classification was introduced by Chen and Boozer in 2009. 4 different categories were introduced, and this is most cited category. There are 4 types in determining implant placement period. Let's look at each one. Type 1, immediate implant placement. Literally, right after extraction or within 1 week, implant is placed. As you can see, bone or soft tissue healing is absent. Immediate implant placement in the socket. There is no bone fill, so it is very difficult to place the implant with initial stability. And if you need bone graft, it is difficult to cover with soft tissue, but if you treat well, the treatment period can be significantly reduced. This is a huge merit. Type 2. 4 to 8 weeks after extraction, implant is placed. After extraction, soft tissue healing is done, but if you open flap, sufficient bone healing is not made. This is how it looks. Because there is no bone fill, when you place the implant, you need to be cautious. But there is less stress in covering it with soft tissue. In the case of type 3, after extraction, 12 to 16 weeks are waited. In number 47, the tooth was extracted. This is after 13 weeks. Soft tissue is quite mature, and you can see bone fill in the socket. The downfall is that you have to wait over 3 months, but when you're doing surgery, there's less stress. So the time offsets the burden on surgery. However, bone fill is not always made very nicely, and depending on the extraction socket, healing can differ. Type 4, you wait for over 6 months. Buccal bone loss and tooth caries led to tooth extraction. In number 46, the patient returned after 2 years. This is the oral state when she came in. You can see that the socket has healed completely, but there's much less volume.
When I open the flap for implant placement, the bone healing is complete, but resorption is very significant. Depending on the state of socket at extraction, healing can differ, but if you look at the scrubs literature, 1 year after extraction, buccal bone loss of 50% can occur. If you wait long, as shown, bone resorption can occur significantly. In such cases, when you place it, implant, advanced techniques are required. A lot of bone graft is required, so you may feel more stressed about surgery. When you do extraction, the extraction socket, even in the case where bone resorption is not severe, this may not result. However, when you do extraction due to perio disease, if you wait long, a lot of bone resorption can occur very frequently. I've talked about the implant placement period. In terms of healing, the contour of the bone with time, it becomes narrower. Inside the socket, bone fill is made with time. Soft tissue, up until certain point, it continues to heal, and at 2 months, soft tissue healing is complete and the form continues to be maintained. You need to understand the healing very well, and it will be very useful in placing your implant. I'm going to talk more on this by showing you the different cases in the next lecture. I've talked about four different categories of implant placement period. Whether you're going to do immediate implant plantation or if you're going to wait a little bit, if you take a look at this table, immediate implant placement, there is no major advantage compared to delayed placement. It's difficult for wound closure. And the surgical site, there's a secondary healing, so there is a possibility of inflammation. Because there is no bone fill, it is very difficult to get initial stability. There are many disadvantages for immediate implant placement, but it has a very strong advantage in the sense that it reduces treatment period, it reduces the number of surgery, and there is less alveolar bone resorption. So it does have some merits. In the case where you wait for healing, you can get nice initial stability and get suture very well. And from surgeon's perspective, there are many advantages. But from patient's perspective, the treatment period becomes longer. When you provide implant treatment, patients often say, when does this treatment end? When I look at the internet, there are one-day implants. Why do I have to take so long? The patients complain. When you decide on implant placement period, you need to form an overall implant treatment strategy. And you, after extraction, as you wait for a socket healing, this is not for just a healing, but this is to get optimum result. You need to explain this to the patient. And if you provide sufficient explanation and form a strategic partnership with the patient, the patient will understand the long wait. Next, I'm going to talk about treatment strategy depending on the socket shape. Earlier, I talked about the four categories of placement period, and now I'm going to talk about how they're affected by extraction socket shape. In the case the extraction socket is sound, if there is just a bone resorption, and when there's also soft tissue resorption, depending on which, there is difference in treatment strategy. So you need to know the classification of extraction socket and build your implant treatment plan accordingly. There are multiple classifications for extraction sockets, so I'm going to talk about Elian's classifications. Elia talked about three different classifications depending on bone resorption and soft tissue resorption, and let's look at each. Type 1. There is no bone and soft tissue resorption, and even if there's a lesion, it is limited to apical area. This is what we call a sound extraction socket. Sometimes we do tooth extraction due to severe fracture or severe caries. After extraction, the bone and soft tissue of socket is well maintained in these cases. Second is there is resorption in the buccal wall and there is no soft tissue resorption. Look at number 12. In the patient mouth, there is no soft tissue resorption. It looks okay. If you look at the image, the palatal wall and buccal wall are all resorbed and extraction was done due to mobility. Type 2, there is no soft tissue resorption but only bone resorption. In the case of type 3, there's both alveolar bone and soft tissue resorption, so implant treatment is very difficult. In those cases, Elia recommends a GBR or orthodontic repositioning to restore the socket shape before implant placement. This is the situation. In number 14, there's soft tissue resorption buccally. When I open the flap, there's also bone resorption. So I'm going to complete my explanation about extraction socket. So I'm going to talk about the treatment strategy for each case in the next lecture as we look at clinical cases. So let's summarize. First, I talked about the placement period depending on extraction socket in four categories. Depending on each period, there's difference in socket healing. How the socket heals, in which period, you need to understand the characteristics, and you need to understand and make a decision when to place the implant. How do you make the decision about when to place the implant? You can use the healing of extraction socket to make the decision. The healing of extraction socket depends on the extraction socket shape. You can use Elian's extraction socket classification on bone resorption and soft tissue resorption. Determining when to place the implant after extraction can be a strategic factor in overall implant strategy. And if you choose accordingly with the extraction socket shape and your surgical technique, I'm sure you'll be able to get good implant outcomes. I talked about the implant placement period and which methods should be used have been discussed. So I'm going to talk about how to come up with treatment strategies depending on different classifications. Please stay tuned. Thank you for watching.
그럼 오늘은 이만 인사드리도록 하겠습니다. 감사합니다.